You fucking did it.
All right, so that's me after having run my very first half marathon. It's so funny, till 60 days ago, I didn't think this was something I could achieve. I had never done any activity which put this much physical strain on it. I'm still pretty sore from it, but not gonna lie, that's the best thing I've done in my entire life in terms of emotionally, physically, and mentally. To give you a bit of a background, till 6 months ago, I couldn't even run half a kilometer. I had gained a lot of weight from my solo travels, and having decided 8 weeks ago that, hey, look, I can run a few Ks here and there, now let's commit to something of this demeanor and let's get it done. So I want to break down this video into three different parts: my training plan, what exactly I did to get to this level, number two being on the final week and what steps and actions I took, and finally I would like to conclude this video on my thoughts on how completing this half marathon really changed my life.
21K is all done, half marathon.
So starting off with the training plan, which I decided to go ahead with for this particular half marathon. So what I did was I went to one of my mates who's a professional runner. He's been running for the last few years. I basically asked him to make one for me with the help of online tools. And we were able to create like a custom training plan, which revolved around me running 3 times a week. First 3 weeks being pretty relaxed. From week 3 to 6, it got pretty intense in terms of my long runs. And finally, in the last 2 weeks, we kept it pretty easy. It started off with a Tuesday being a small 30-minute or a 40-minute easy run. Tried to run in zone 2. So I don't know if you know already, there are 5 different kinds of zones when you're running. I would highly recommend each and every one of us to run in zone 2 for easy run on a Tuesday or a Monday. And then day 2 of my running would basically revolve around interval training, signing up with a 5 to 10-minute warm-up and then running quickly, and then walking for a minute. It was a very intense training, which I really hated because I'd rather run at a particular pace. That's personally something which I didn't really enjoy as much. But look, you have to get through it, right? Then finally, day 3 was the long run day personally. This is something which I would run on a Sunday morning from 8 to 10, preferably. Nice and early, I would wake up and I would basically go out and run 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, all the way up to 18 kilometers, 3 weeks out from my half marathon day. To break it down even further, I'll attach a photo of my exact running plan, which you guys can refer for yourself. Second thing which I did all throughout my 8 weeks of prep was the fact I made sure that I was eating all this healthy food and I was carb loading the night before my long run. When you're running for long distances, at least for more than an hour, your body burns through a majority of your carbs. So it's highly recommended by, you know, professional runners that you basically have a lot of carbs and a lot of calories the day before so that you can ease through your run the day before. So I would eat things such as pasta, porridge, oats, rice, anything which is filled with complex carbs, just to get through my long runs. Now, the key question which beginners have and which I had was, what kind of gear do I need to start off with? If I'm being very honest with you guys, for the first 6 weeks out of my 8 week training, I ran with my basic Nike runners. So I had these Nike Air Pegasus 40. I got them for $90 from Nike outlet store. And to be honest, those shoes were perfectly fine for someone like me. And then in week 6, I decided to basically spend some money and I went for these Hoka Bondi 8, which is actually what I ran in my half marathon as well. So I didn't go for any of those carbon plated shoes yet because I didn't feel the need to. But if you think that will assist you, definitely go for it. There's quite a few different options out there. Make sure you're spending and investing some decent amount of money on comfy training shoes because they really make a big difference, which I realized after buying my Hokas. Second key thing was hydration. The night before a long run, I would basically have one bottle of Hydralyte or one of those Gatorade or Powerade, get my body hydrated, because when you run for long distances, you end up losing a lot of electrolytes. So that really helps. So to help with all the hydration, I would basically drink one of these Maximas. I would have coconut water and finally a couple of Hydralytes the night before. All of these different things really helped me with hydration. When I decided to run past 14 kilometers, I started taking gels because I feel like they really help when you're running for an hour and a half plus. I went onto my Amazon and I found this brand called GU. They're quite basic and I got these non-caffeinated gels, which I'll be honest with you, I was quite happy with. 3 of these during my half marathon. Last gear I had was a running belt, which really makes your life easier. You could put everything in here. And yeah, that's basically it, to be honest. And now leading on to the supplements, which I took every single night during those 60 days, was basically I used to have magnesium every single night, I had ashwagandha, and finally I used to have fish oil, which would help with my overall body's health. So these were the supplements which I was having during those 60 days just to help with my recovery. I think they really helped with all the bodies, all the joint pains, because when you're running for such long distance, it puts a lot of pressure on your joints and your muscles. So it's good to have these dietary supplements if you can basically afford it. Now moving on to the last thing, and this is something which not many people talk about, it's consistency. So it's quite easy for us to make these nice, fancy 8-week plans, 6-week plans. The hardest part is being consistent. Looking at my 8-week plan, I still remember one of the weeks I had to skip my long run purely because I was helping my mates, you know, move houses. There were days where it was fucking cold and rainy where I didn't feel like running at all. In fact, I decided to run even though it was not the most ideal situation. That's what got me to the end where I felt comfortable and confident. I would say I was pretty consistent overall, and that's something which is really important with any of these training plans you decide to go ahead with. Now moving on to the final week before the actual race, because my race was interstate, I had to fly down to Melbourne 3 days before the actual race. I made sure that, you know, in that week I kept it pretty easy. So any training plan you go with, the last week should be very easy, where you should just do one or two easy 30-minute runs, not putting any kind of, you know, pressure on your legs or your calf, just so that, you know, you can perform well and optimally on the race day, which was a Sunday morning for me. And that's what I decided to do. I only ran twice that week, on a Tuesday and a Thursday, a 30-minute easy run, low tempo, zone two running. Moving on to the actual race day, I basically got to the event 45 minutes to an hour early, purely because I knew how crazy the queues will be for restrooms. I decided to warm up even before getting to the actual site. In terms of what I actually consumed on the day of the race, I had one coffee shot. Well, the audio kind of got mucked up and I'm having to reshoot this last bit on what exactly happened on the race day. If you ask me, the race day was the best day out of the entire 8-week training cycle. It's actually like the exam day if you ask me, where, to be honest, there is no pressure per se, but you deliver to what you have trained for, right? This was the most fun day of my entire life. Imagine this. You're there with 26,000 other people who have also put in all this hard work and effort, who are there running alongside of you. So it's a lot more fun than training, you know, by yourself during those 8 weeks. That's my biggest tip for you. Make sure you have fun in that moment, right? So to sum up, training for my half marathon with only 8 weeks of training was a great idea. I think it was definitely worth it. And if that's something which you're considering yourself, make sure you sign up for the first half marathon and pay for that actual ticket. So this way you'll stay committed and have fun training for it. The fact you get a medal at the end of it is not really what drove me for that half marathon. It was the fact, like, you know, I've had to put in all this hard work and I put myself through this journey of being disciplined, you know, training 3 times a week and, you know, eating all the right things before the race day. The process is actually more enjoyable than the outcome of it, in my opinion. But trust me, it's all worth it. If you guys found this really useful, make sure to hit that like button for the YouTube algorithm. Comment down below on your thoughts on a half marathon, and make sure you also put in the date, if you have watched this video till this far, on when exactly you plan on doing your first ever half marathon. Until then, take care and I'll see you in the next one.